Okay, we are on Masechet Murah, Perek Vav, Mishnah Gimel, third Mishnah in the sixth chapter of Masechet Murah. Let's first dedicate our learning to the memory of Yonah Hillel ben Yitzchak Selengat. And I, of course, invite you to join our Mishnah, daily Mishnah WhatsApp group, bit.ly/daily Mishnah. Okay, let's go back to the Mishnah. The Mishnah we talked about in the Psukim. We're going to go back to Dvarim Perek Chav Gimel, which we learned, Perek Chav Gimel, Pasuk Yud Tet. We learned you couldn't bring Ednan Zona or Mechir Keleb, the hire of a harlot or the price of a dog. So we've learned what Ednan Zona is. But now we're going to learn what is Mechir Keleb? What is the halachic status of a price of a dog? Says the Mishnah. Is it Mechir Keleb? What is the price of a dog? Meaning, what is considered the exchange of a dog? It's not money. Because remember, you sell something, if you have Mechir Keleb. We're going to learn in the next Mishnah. There's the actual item itself. That you can't offer the thing that's exchanged for the dog or given for the price of the heart of the harlot. So therefore, Ha'omer l'chaberu, a same person says to his friend, Hey lach taleze tachat kelev ze. Take this sheep, okay, instead of this dog, meaning it's an exchange. That's mechir kelev. You sold the sheep for the dog. Mechen shnei shutafim shechalku. Similarly, two partners who divided, split up. Echadna, meaning they're dividing up, they have their two partners, and they're dividing up their herd, okay? And they split up and they said, Echad natal asara, one took 10 sheep, the Echad natal tisha, one took 9, v'kelev, and a dog. So the Mishnah says, Shekeneged kelev asurim, those that are opposite on the other side of the dog are prohibited. They're called mechir kelev. But she'im hakelev, those that are with the dog, mutarim, they are permitted. The Bartanura adds the following, okay? What does that mean? Keneged asara talim, all of them that are corresponding to the 10 tla'im, shenatal chaveiro. Okay, those 10 against the 9 in the keleb, kulam asurim mishum mechir keleb. All of them are asur. Why is this? I'll show you in a chart. Shimon, Reuben and Shimon have 19 sheep together. They own 19 sheep. Let me a little bit bigger. Okay, we'll move the doggy over here. Okay, now they have 19 sheep and a dog. Okay, Shimon takes 10, and Reuben takes 9. So according to the Mishnah, those that are kineged akelev on Shimon's side, meaning the exchange, is those are all considered mechir kelev, every single one of them. Whereas all of these guys on this side, they're regular, not mechir kelev. Okay, so now the Gemara asks the following. The Bartanura says, well, that's from the Gemara asks the following. Gemara parich, and the Gemara asks, Amai kineged akelev kulam masubim? Why are they all prohibited? Those that are against, nepuk chad laadei kalba. If they pick one that corresponds to the dog. The Hanach Kulu Lishteru. Let's go back to our little picture. Why are all these guys Asur? Say, okay, you got your dog. I understand, right? One of them is Mechir Kelev. Okay? Say, okay, this one, that's a Mechir Kelev guy, and the rest of them should be okay. Why are all of them? So the Bartanura answers. The Gemara says the following. Umishane, it answers. Hacha, b'mayiskin. What are we talking about? What case are we talking about? Kegon de tfe dme kelev mechad minayu. The money, dme kelev, is tfeis more than the value of one of the sheep. You don't have any of the sheep that are valued the same value as the dog. The dog, the price of the dog is 100 shekel. All the sheep, the maximum value of any of the sheep is 90 for a sheep, 90 shekel. Yeah, we'll give them 90. Okay, so therefore, all of them are worth 90 or less. So therefore, you don't have any one of them that corresponds to the dog value. So it's always going to be one plus. Which one? All of them, the value of all of them are connected, and that's why it's considered mechir kelev. But if, in fact, the value of one of these guys was, in fact, higher, was 100 or whatever, then if it was like 110 or whatever, then you'd pick that one and say, that one is mechir kelev, and the rest of them are not mechir kelev and can be offered in the Beit HaMikdash. That's what the Gemara says. The Mishnah continues. Etnan kelev mechir zonah. What if, remember, in the Pasuk it says, etnan zonah mechir kelev. What if it's the other way around? Etnan kelev, the hire of a dog, which is difficult to even contemplate, u'mechir zona, and you sold a prostitute, you sold a harlot. Hare elu mutarim. Now that's okay, you can offer them on the Mizbeach. Shneamar, shnayim. Let's go back to shnayim below arba. Let's go back to the pasuk that we saw before. Okay? Of Edon zana mechir kelev, you shouldn't bring it to the Beit Hashem Elokecha lechol neder for any vow. Ki to'avat Hashem Elokecha gam shneihem. Both of them are considered abomination. Shnayim and shneihem. So the Mishnah says we divide it up into two. It says shnayim velo arba. Only those two and not the other way around. And moreover, v'ladotehem mutarim, their offspring, if it happens to be that one of those animals has an offspring, it's permitted. You can offer the offspring in the Mishnah. Hen velo v'ladotehem. What does it mean, hen? Says the Bartanura, Okay? We take the word and we split it into shnayim, shnehem, shnayim, hen. So shnayim means them and not the opposite. And hen, hen, velo, velarotem. Right? We already dedicate our learning, so make it a great day.